top six answers on the board. Name something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
Frying pan.
Frying pan.
A gun.
Detroit, a gun. Glad we finally over here.
Woo. Come on.
Here it is. Name something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
A knife. I'm that crazy. I'm that crazy.
You that girl?
Come on.
You that
I'm originally from Chicago. Oh. I'm repping Detroit, but I'm from Chicago.
By way of Haiti.
That's true.
By way of Haiti.
By way of Haiti.
Oh, I know she got it.
Yeah, yeah. Come on.
A knife. Antoine, name something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
My phone.
Good answer.
That's the realest answer. My phone. Tony, name something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
His wallet.
His wallet, yeah. Oh. Okay, that was a good answer. All right, Theon, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. The Van Horn family can steal. Give me something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
Pot of boiling water.
A pot of boiling water. Name something a wife would be holding that would really get her husband's attention.
Divorce papers.
Good.
Divorce papers! Number six. Five.
Toys to use a banana.
Yeah. Number two.
His feet.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Number one.
Lingerie.
Top four answers on the board. We asked 100 married women. Name a reason a Kardashian wouldn't be interested in your husband. Nick.
Not wealthy enough.
Not wealthy.
We gotta play.
Jay, 100 women. Name a reason a Kardashian wouldn't be interested in your husband.
Too ugly.
Two others.
Oh, it's okay.
All right. Lisa, 100 married women. Name a reason a Kardashian wouldn't be interested in your husband.
He's not famous.
He's not famous. We got two strikes. We got to be careful now, folks. Come on. If it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other family can steal and play sudden death.
Because he's not tall enough?
Because he's not tall enough.
That's good. That's good.
Family, here's the situation. I got three answers left on this board. If you give me either one of those answers, your family steals, and your family gets to play sudden death.
All right.
But if it's not there, the Adams family wins the game. We ask 100 married women, name a reason a Kardashian wouldn't be interested in your husband.
Because he's too old.
Because he's too old. Number Top five answers on the board. Name an occupation where you might have to do the splits. Jason.
Gymnastics.
Gymnastics. Walk off. Pass it. Yes, go ahead. Matt, name an occupation where you might have to do splits.
Well, I can't do this, but maybe in bed.
Ooh!
My hero.
Joe said he's my hero. I don't know what occupation that is, but okay. Oh, okay. In bed. Joe, name an occupation where you might have to do the splits.
Athlete.
Athlete. All right, Katie. Let's slow down now. We got two strikes. Come on. Adam's family can steal here. Katie, name an occupation where you might have to do the splits.
I'm going to say you work at a restaurant, like if the split shifts with your coworkers.
Work at a restaurant doing split shifts. Name an occupation where you might have to do the splits.
Steve, we're going to say stripper.
Stripper! Number five.
Yoga instructor.
Four.
Dancer ballet.
Two.
Cheerleader.
Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 women, your guy is no Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Spend money.
Adam, spend money.
Sex.
Oh, okay. Sex. Yeah! Pass the point.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Karen? All right, let's go. Talk to 100 women. Your guy knows Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Talk.
Talk.
Oh, good answer. Good answer.
Talk slash lie. Ashley, talk to 100 women. Your guy knows Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Fall asleep.
Fall asleep. Kristen? Your guy's no Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Walk.
Walk?
That's a good answer.
Hannah, what do you do?
I am a full-time student at the University of West Georgia. I'm an early childhood education major, so hopefully I'll be a teacher when I get done.
Yeah.
That's what we're gonna do then. All right, Hannah. Your guy's no Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
I'm gonna go with eat, Steve.
Eat. Caitlin, your guy's no Superman. What's he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Drive, Steve.
Drive, yeah. Hey, Miss Karen, your guy's no Superman. What's he do faster than a speeding bullet?
Cheat.
Oh!
Cheat. Well, we got two strikes, Ashley. Boy, the family can steal. Threw me off a little bit there. Your guy's no Superman, but what does he do faster than a speeding bullet?
I'm gonna say get dressed.
Yeah. Get dressed. All right, family, we talked to 100 women. Your guy's no Superman, but he does what's faster than a speeding bullet?
Go with change the channel, Steve.
Change the channel. Number five.
Chuck Booms.
8 answers are on the board. Name something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for during an examination. Andrea.
A needle.
A needle. Pass the point.
We're gonna play!
We're gonna play. Andrea, how you doing?
I'm doing good, and yourself, Steve?
All right, introduce everybody.
Okay, I have my mom, Cindy Diane Stroud. I have my dad, Anthony Stroud. I have my brother, Anthony M. Stroud. Right. And I have my little cousin, Devontae Singletary.
Welcome to the show. All righty, name something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for doing an examination.
Cotton swabs.
Cotton swabs. Anthony, what do you do, sir?
I've been working for Penske for 34 years.
Penske?
Penske Truck Leasing.
Trucking, all right.
For 34 years.
Oh, that's good, man.
Yes, sir.
Wow. That's pretty good. Mr. Anthony, give me something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for doing an examination.
The knife, Steve.
The knife! Name something you hope the doctor don't reach for doing an examination.
My testicle, Steve.
A little too quick for you, Doc. OP don't reach for his testicles. Devontae, give me something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for doing an examination.
The hammer? It's not a hammer, though.
You want the little hammer from you? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Hammer! Now we got 2 strikes now. We need to be careful, family. Andrea, name something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for doing an examination.
A urine cup for a drug screening.
The urine cup! The urine cup. Name something you hope your doctor doesn't reach for doing an examination.
A defibrillator.
That's up there?
It's gonna be up there.
It's up there.
Yeah,
Steve.
It's
up there.
That's
well, you
not
don't want
an examination. That's trying to bring your ass back. You're gone. Defibrillator. Number 8.
Scissors.
7.
Speculum.
6.
Foam to post sticks.
5.
Rubber gloves.
That's what you don't want. Yeah. Number 4. Top 8 answers on the board. Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her saggy boobies.
Her saggy boobs.
Her teeth.
Her teeth. Would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
The limp, Steve.
Got rid of
the
what?
The walk. The limp in the walk.
The limp.
In the walk.
Okay. Grandma, get rid of that limp. Devontae, Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her cane.
Her cane.
Good answer. Good answer.
All right, now, Andrea, we got 2 strikes, the other family can steal. Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her wig.
Great answer.
Good answer.
Yes!
Good answer! Her wig! All right, we're gonna need another one now. We need a big one. Come on. Come on now, Miss Cindy. We got 2 strikes. Aubergast family can steal. Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her glasses.
Her glasses! Yes. Anthony, come on, man. Point values, two strikes. Anthony,
come on, Anthony.
Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her wrinkles. I think I got it, Steve.
Number six?
Nah.
All right, Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
The church hat, Steve. It's up there, Steve.
I sure hope it is. The only thing I'm worried about is it might be number six. The church hat!
Oh! I told you, Steve.
Boy, that's such a damn stretch.
Let's reread the question for me.
Could I reread the question for you?
Make sure I'm there.
I don't have it. Short ass. Always. Grandma, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Other family can steal. I think we got enough now. Grandma would look 20 years younger if she got rid of what?
Her husband.
If she got rid of Grandpa. Andrea, two strikes. Abigail's family could steal. Grandma looked 20 years younger. She could get rid of what?
Her bad knees.
Her bad knees. Grandma would look 20 years younger. She got rid of what?
Her weight, Steve.
Got rid of her weight. Number one. Top eight answers on the board, ladies. Calling your wife Bunny is a term of endearment. Calling her what animal is not? Mary Jo.
Dog.
Dog. Katie.
Elephant.
Elephant. Pass the
point. Play.
We're gonna play. How you doing?
I'm doing great, Steve.
What do you do for a living, Mary Jo?
I am the principal of Christ the King Catholic School in Wichita. Go Soldiers!
Oh, yeah! You're the principal?
I'm the principal,
well,
yes.
Well, I spent a lot of time down at your office. Well, that's pretty good. Mary Jo, introduce everybody.
I have my youngest son, Luke, my daughter-in-law, Maddie, my oldest son, Connor, and my husband of 35 years, who I just happened to have met in a bar, Sean.
What do you do, Luke?
I'm a senior at Kansas State. I'm studying biology. I want to be a medical student, and I got one more year, yeah.
A medical student, yeah. What type of doctor are you doing?
I'm thinking either cardiovascular, so like heart or kidney, and specialize in surgery.
Luke, man, good luck to you.
I appreciate it.
I know you're going to do well. All right, let's go. Luke! Calling your wife Bunny is a term of endearment. Calling her what animal is not?
Rat.
Rat. Ooh.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. Maddie, calling your wife Bunny is a term of endearment. Calling her what is not?
Snake.
Snake.
Good answer. Good answer.
Connor, how long y'all been married?
2.5 years. We met when we were 8 years old, but she didn't like me then. When I turned 16, I got my braces off and it was game over.
She met you at 8, didn't like you, got your braces off at 16. You wore braces for 8 years?
No.
The hell was wrong with you? All right, man, calling your wife Bunny is a term of endearment. Calling her what animal is not?
A donkey, a jackass.
Donkey! Sean, calling your wife Bunny's a term of endearment. Calling her what animal is not?
A cow.
A cow! Ooh, good answer. Mary Jo, calling your wife Bunny's a term of endearment. Calling her what animal's not?
A pig.
Pig. Yeah. Luke, calling your wife Bunny's a term of endearment. Calling her what animal is not?
Cat.
Cat. Good answer. Maddie, two strikes. Van Horn family can steal. Calling your wife Bunny's a term of endearment. Calling her what animal's not?
Tiger.
Tiger.
Good answer, man.
Calling your wife Bunny's a term of endearment. Calling her what animal's not?
A horse.
A horse.
Good answer. Good answer.
Number eight.
Whale. Wow.
Seven. Top six answers on the board. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as her stage name.
Pearl.
Pearl. Yeah.
Ruby.
Ruby. Two old ass strippers. The big dog. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as a stage name.
Emerald.
Emerald.
That's on there.
Hey, guess whose turn it is? I know you know this. Come on, girl. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as a stage name.
I'm gonna say sapphire.
Sapphire! Kavika. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as a stage name.
Diamond.
Yeah,
Diamond.
Come on, girl.
Kiafa. Yes. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as her stage name.
Steve, I'm gonna go with Aqua.
What?
Good answer.
Aqua?
Good answer.
Blue eyes.
Here we go, man. Come on. Name a gemstone a stripper might use as a stage name.
Topaz.
Woo! Topaz! All right, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. Tell me a gemstone a stripper might use as a stage name.
Gemini. Oh.
Gemini! Okay. Tell me a gemstone that a stripper might use as a stage name.
We gotta go with Jade, Steve.
Jade! Number five. Oh. Top eight answers on the board. Name something a man might give a woman on the first date to make sure there's a second. Debbie.
Flowers.
Flowers. Pass the plate.
Let's play this game.
Play.
Kayla.
Sir.
Name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure it's a second.
A kiss.
Woo! A kiss. Hey, Hey, Hannah, name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure there's a second.
How about a ride home?
A ride home. Megan, name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure there's a second.
His full attention.
His full attention. Gary, we got only one strike. Name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure there's a second.
Some sex. Somebody had to say it.
Miss Debbie?
Yes?
Name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure there's a second.
Maybe some jewelry.
Woo! Good answer!
I just met you. Jewelry! We got two strikes. We got to be careful now, Kayla. The Bartley family can steal.
Candy.
Hannah, we back to you again. We got two strikes. Bartley family can steal. Name something a man might give a woman on the first date and make sure there's a second.
Chivalry. Like a gentleman.
I like the way it sounds. I like the way it... Chivalry. Name something a man might give a woman on the first date to make sure there's a second.
Steve, I'm going my own money. Yeah. Good answer, good answer, good answer.
I thought maybe you gave me some money.
You went on your own on that
one?
You didn't go with the crew? Because Yolanda looked like she thinking, if money ain't up there, then you gonna be up there.
Oh, okay.
How you wanna do this? You better hold money up there, because if it ain't, you finna be up there.
Exactly.
I'm tired of this. Money! Number eight. Number three.
It's number.
Top seven answers on the board. You sent an anonymous text to your boss. It might say, you have the worst what?
Hours.
You have the worst hours.
Work ethic.
Work ethic.
Get praise.
Pete, how you doing, man?
Hi, Steve Harvey.
Good, good. What do you do, sir?
I'm a first grade teacher in Irvington, New York. Love those kids. Thank you. Yay, teachers!
Okay, good. We'll introduce everybody.
Okay, yeah. So this is my cousin Samantha. This is my cousin Keith. This is my cousin Kristen. And down there is my cousin Emily.
Yay! Welcome to the show. Samantha, what do you do?
I am a speech language pathologist supervisor for the New York City Department of Ed, and I work in the Bronx. Why are you making that face? Yeah.
Speech language pathologist. You'll be having trouble with most of the stuff I say. Samantha, you sent an anonymous text to your boss. It might say you have the worst what?
Smell.
You have the worst smell. Keith, what do you do, sir?
How you doing, Steve? I work in a recording studio as an audio engineer.
Oh, my man.
Yeah, recording voiceovers for commercials, movies, podcasts, audiobooks, stuff like that.
Oh, that's good, man. Keith, you send an anonymous text to your boss. It might say you have the worst what?
What about coworkers?
You have the worst coworkers. Hey, Kristen.
Hi.
Send a text to your boss. It might say you have the worst what?
Office.
You have the worst office. Emily, you sent a text to your boss anonymously. It might say you have the worst what?
Attitude.
Attitude! Peter, you send an anonymous text to your boss. It might say you have the worst what?
Salary.
Salary. All right, we got two strikes. We got to slow it down. Chapel family can steal, Samantha. Send an anonymous text to your boss. It might say you have the worst what?
Job.
You have the worst job. Family, you send an anonymous text to your boss and it might say you have the worst what?
Benefit, Steve.
The worst benefit. Number seven.
Close ever.
Six.
Manners.
Three.